That date that's shown there, is that May 16th of 2014?
Yes.
The first call is Granville Ritchie, Granville Ashanti Ritchie. Did you put that name in your phone?
Yes, please.
And prior to learning his name was Granville Ritchie, what did you have, how did you have him saved in your phone?
Travel.
And the 727-288-3413, was that his phone number that you communicated with him?
No.
That's not his phone number that you communicated with him?
No.
What was his phone number then?
His phone number is 727.
So that was Granville Ritchie. And on May 16th of 2014, it showed at 11:11 p.m., there was a phone call between you and Granville Ritchie.
Correct.
Did you call him or did he call you?
He called me.
Was that a long conversation or a short conversation?
It was a short conversation.
Do you recall what the conversation was about on that day?
Yeah. Okay, before then, his mom had asked me to talk to him on going back to work. So that day when he called me, he said, "Baby, I'm listening to you and I'm ready to go back to work. I want us to, to move out of the state and start a family, start a relationship, get a better relationship. What happened? I'm happy. I was happy.
What is it that his mother, Granville Ritchie's mother, had previously asked you to talk about him going back to work?
When I was down here.
In January of 2014?
Correct, yeah.
Was this an ongoing conversation for the two of you, for him to start going back to work?
Yes.
And so on that day when he called you at 11:11 p.m., did he sound upset or stressed in any way?
No.
Did he sound the way he normally did on all the other times you had spoken to him?
Yeah, he sounded, it was different because nobody don't talk to me like the way he was talking, being nice on the phone, so I'm surprised.
Do you mean talking about your future and moving forward in your relationship?
Right. Because you never say nothing like that, so I'm happy.
Yeah. Did he tell you where he was at that time that he had called you?
No, he didn't tell me where he was at the time. No, he had texted me before then and said he would call me in 15 minutes and that's when he called. He didn't tell me where he was.
Showing you states exhibit X2, it begins with one text that had occurred the night before on May 15th of 2014 and then continues on starting with May 16th of 2014. Messaging between, these messages between you and Granville Ritchie?
Yes.
And again, is that his name, how it was saved in your phone up at the top?
Yes, please.
With his phone number underneath the name?
Yes.
Now, what color are your text messages in?
Blue.
And what color are his, Granville Ritchie's text messages in?
Yellow.
Was it normal for you to greet each other in the morning through text such as these?
Yes, I normally do that.
States Exhibit X3 is a continuation on. Was it typical for you to communicate throughout the day, such as this show starting in the morning and continuing out through the midday. Was it a habit that you all would talk starting in the morning, in the middle of the afternoon, and continue on through the day? Would you talk a bunch each day, or was it usually one contact and that was it?
It just depended. It wasn't like everybody said no. Just depended. Yeah.
And in Mississippi, were you on Central Time or Eastern Standard Time? Central Time in Mississippi?
Yeah.
So Central Time, that's 1 hour behind Eastern Standard Time?
Right.
So is your phone, when you are in Mississippi, your phone comes up Central Time, comes up the time where you're located in Mississippi?
Right.
Is that correct?
Correct, yeah.
So going back to States Exhibit 1X, a call being at 11:11 p.m. Central Time is 12:11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And the time for that these texts come through, is it the time that's underneath the message, the time that it had been sent?
Yes.
On States Exhibit X3, to continue on, you had made a statement that you had been at work that day.
Mm-hmm.
And what is it that he had asked from you?
I think he said he was broke that he knew some money.
And can you speak up just a little bit?
Oh yeah, he said he was broke that he knew some money. Yeah, he was stressed.
Were you able to give him money on that day?
Yeah, I sent him $150.
States Exhibit X4. Originally, did you tell him that you didn't have money, but then you were able to get some?
Yes, I told him I was broke.
Where did you get the $150 from?
I mean, I had to go into my account, and I'm getting my account. Yeah.
So you had it in your account?
Right.
States Exhibit X5. Does this show that you were messaging him about sending him the money?
Yes, please.
And so you text, I got $150 from you heading to Walmart to send it, your name or mom's. What do you mean by that?
Yes, I was asking if I should use his name or his mom's.
And why did you, what do you mean use his name or his mom's?
Yeah, because a lot of times when he asked me for something, he would ask me to use his mom's name.
And is that to send money?
Yes.
And so on that date, who did you send the $150 to? His name or his mother's name?
I sent it to his mom's name.
And when you send this money to his mom's name, is this like a wire transfer?
Yes.
And was that done at Walmart in Mississippi on that date?
Yes.
Now he responds later, please baby, stress out, just wake up, think, send that shit to Grinball Richie.
Right.
Had you gotten that message prior to sending the money?
Yes, I have sent the money before. Yeah.
You sent the money before you got his message that he wanted you to send it to him?
Correct.
And is that where you begin to tell him? Did you text, oh my God, OMG, is that oh my God?
Yes.
Already did it in mom's name?
Yes.
Were you trying to figure out if there was something you could do to fix that?
I mean, I have just did it, so I know it's either way he was going to come to receive the money, so.
You knew his mother would give him money?
Yes, right. Yeah.
But you're asking him, what should I do? Were you going to try to fix it?
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes, I was, because I didn't know whether he, I think he had told me that his mom was at work then on the phone. So yeah, so I was trying to figure out if I should go back and change the name to his name on his mom.
it's exhibit X7. The blue message there sent at 6:11 p.m. Lori Gibson from Ivy Van, 38219STR, Meridian, Mississippi, with a zip code and a reference number, $150. Did you text that?
Yes.
And what is that?
Okay, that's the reference number that when she's go to Walmart to get it, they'll need the reference number and that information.
To be able to pick up the money?
Yes.
State's exhibit X8. Your messages are in blue and Granville's messages, Granville Rich's messages are in the yellow. Why are you sending him messages, yes, baby, talk to me, baby, Trevor, please talk to me?
I forget what it was, but a lot of times when you call me or you text and you don't answer, so yeah. And I don't know if...
There's speculation.
Would that be common that you would text him and say, please talk to me? If you had texted him and you hadn't gotten a response, then you would try again to get him to talk to you?
Right.
State's exhibit X9. There's a text message that was sent at 10:54 p.m. Central Time that he texted you a call. A call in 15, okay, and you respond back, okay. Did Granville call you after sending that text message?
Yes, I think, yeah. Yes, I did call.
And showing you State's Exhibit 1X, that text that you said, a call in 15, okay, at 10:54 p.m., you then received a call at 11:11 p.m., from Granville Ridge, is that correct?
Correct.
And that's the short conversation that you previously discussed?
Yes, right.
Continuing on to the morning of May 17th, 2014, you texted, good morning, baby, I slept good last night. Thanks for realizing how much I love you. Was that in response to the conversation that you had had with him about him wanting to move the relationship forward?
Yes.
State's exhibit X10, and it's a continuation on of that original message that we had just read. Thanks for realizing how much I love you. That's all I want from you. Love you so much. I'm at work. And he responds back, love you and more. State's exhibit X11. All thanks, baby. I'm crazy in love with you. That was your text message?
Yeah.
Were you in love with him back in May 2014?
I think I was.
And he responds back, I feel the same. And again, did you call him baby?
Yeah.
State's exhibit X12. You're texting him, Dan, baby, are you okay? Did you know, did you believe there was something wrong prior to sending that text, or was there something that happened, or you were just texting that because you hadn't heard from him in a long period of time?
I think I had texting and there wasn't no reply, so yeah, that's when I said, yeah, baby, are you okay? Yeah.
And then he responds back 2 minutes later, know I'm at the police station, they want to ask me questions, but soon call you. Was that the first time you had heard that he was at the police station?
Yes.
And you respond back, OMG, what's going on?
Yes.
And he told you, relax, call Vivit.
Right.
Vivit, is that his mother?
Yes.
And did you have her phone number?
Yes, I have her phone number.
State's Exhibit X-13. You respond back, okay, she's not answering, baby, you okay?
Yes, I did.
Did you call, did you attempt to call Vivit after he told you to?
Yes, I did.
X-14. You respond, baby, you okay? He writes back, I let you know, okay, baby. You respond, okay, and again, he texts, did you talk to Viv?
Right.
Is that his mother, Vivette?
Yes.
For Vivit?
Yeah.
And you respond back, she said she was gonna call me right back, but she hasn't.
Yes.
State's Exhibit X-15. He responds, yes, I did, but I'm wondering what is going now because I'm not charged, but I'm here 7 HRS. Is that for 7 hours?
Yes.
Now, at that point, did you know why he was being questioned by law enforcement?
No.
You text back, what are you talking about? What you did? X-16, he responds back in all capital letters. So you want me to text you or just you what I did? Question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark. Really, do you even think sometimes? Would he normally text you in capital letters like that?
No.
And you respond back because you send this text to me. You continue on to say, yes, I did, but I was wondering what is going now because I'm not charged, but here I'm here 7 hours now. You texted back what he had previously texted you.
Right, I forwarded that back to him.
Why did you forward that back to him?
Because I was trying to let him know that he sent me this, and now I'm worried, and asking him what's going on, but, you know, he's telling me, like, the right thing sometimes.
In other words, he wasn't going to tell you if he had done something.
Right.
Or the text message. And he responds back, yes, I sent that meeting. I'm still here. Can't ask me quest like that, Ivy. X-18. Just wait, okay, love. And you apologize. And then it goes on into Sunday, which is May 18th of 2014.
Correct.
And are you checking in to see how he's doing?
Correct.
Had you heard back from him that night?
No.
Did he ever tell you why he was being questioned from law enforcement?
He never told me.
When was the first time that you learned why law enforcement was questioning him back on May 17th of 2014?
When they came to my job.
When the federal agents came to your job? That's the first time you learned about the investigation involving Granville Ritchie?
Yes, please.
And was that towards the end of May of 2014?
Yes, please.
Do you know how old Granville Ritchie was when you were dating him? Ms. Pham, 13 showing you what the pre-marked estate exhibit 02. Do you recognize this photograph?
Yeah.
How is it that you recognize it?
I remember the car.
And is this photograph fairly accurately depict a silver Lexus, the car you recognize as being Rainbow Ridge? Prior to the federal agents coming out to speak to you, had you ever heard of the name Calissa Kelly?
No.
Had you ever heard of the name Ebony Wiley?
No.
In one of the text messages on the early morning hours of May 16th of 2014, Rainbow Ritchie had asked you for $150.
Correct.
Or, I'm sorry, he had asked you for money. Was that the first time that he had asked you for money?
No.
How many times prior had he asked you for money?
So many times.
No further questions.
Good afternoon. I believe you first met Randall Ritchie in October of 2013, is that correct?
I don't recall, but I think it was around somewhere around September, October, something like that.
Okay. Do you recall speaking with an FBI agent by the name of Robert Haar on or about May 22nd, 2014? No, I believe ATF agent, I'm sorry, Robert Hart, I met with you in Mississippi.
Yes, I don't recall the name, but yeah, they came to Mississippi.
ATF?
Yes.
Okay. And they came to you to talk to you about Randall Ritchie?
Yes.
Okay. And when you met with them, were you truthful with them?
Yes.
Okay. And might it refresh your memory as to when you met General Ritchie, if you could look at the report and the statement that you gave to them about when you met him? Yeah.
It was 2013, but I don't remember the date.
Okay. I had asked you earlier if it was October 2013, and you said October or September.
Yes, yes, yeah.
Okay.
I went towards the end, towards the end of the year, so.
All right. Do you recall telling agents that it was around October 2013?
I don't recall that.
You went to visit, but when you met Randall Ritchie initially, you knew him as Trevor.
Correct.
And it wasn't until a later time that you learned his formal name is Randall Ritchie.
Correct.
Now, the name Trevor, however, was a name that he went by, correct?
Yeah, that's what he told me.
Right. And it wasn't just you that called him Trevor, his mother called him Trevor, correct?
No,
okay, so you don't know whether or not his mother called him Trevor?
No.
Okay, she may have called him Trevor?
Maybe she will, but I have no idea.
Okay, and do you know whether or not his other family members referred to him as Trevor?
I don't know none of his family besides his mom.
Okay, so as far as whether or not that was the nickname that he went by with family and friends, then they very well be, right?
Maybe, I don't
know if I can tell me Trevor. Sure, sure. But clearly, when you said my name is Trevor, obviously that wasn't his full name, right? Normally you have a first name and a last name at a minimum?
Right, but yeah.
Okay. Did you feel like he was deceiving you by calling saying his name was Trevor?
I mean, if you meet somebody and they tell me their name,
Right. And obviously, when he asked you to send him money, you didn't send money to travel.
Right, I sent it to his mom, then let her to his grandmother, which.
Okay. You indicated that, on several occasions, you've indicated that the last time you came to Tampa to stay with Grandma Richie was in January of 2014.
Correct.
Might it be that that's the first time you came?
No, that was the last time.
Do you recall telling the agent from ATF that the first time you came to visit him in Florida was in January 2014? And did you stay for 10 days?
No.
Do you recall telling the agent that the second time you visited him in Florida was in March of 2014?
No.
Do you recall telling him that the third time you visited him in Florida was in April 2014, and that you remained for 10 days, returning home about April 28th of 2014?
No, I don't know.
If you might have refreshed your memory to look at the narrative of your statement to the agents.
Okay.
If I could approach. I'm sure you're just page 2 of the report of Agent Hart. And paragraph 6, if you want to review that just for yourself. Chance to review it? Give you more time? Do you recall now having reviewed that? Does that have a fresher memory as to telling the agent the times that you visited Grandma Richie in Florida? Testimony that you did not tell the agent that you came to Florida to visit in January, March, and April of 2014?
No, I know I talked to the agent, but I don't recall the dates.
As you sit here today, do you recall the dates?
I still don't recall the date.
Okay. So when you said earlier that it was January, that was the last time, it could be that it was April that was the last time.
Yeah, because when you come in, the tag on my luggage, that was the
sure. The tag of the luggage says January, right? Which is consistent with you being there in January of 2014.
Uh-huh.
Yes?
Yes.
And my recollection is that you had a set of doctors' luggage, right?
Correct.
In fact, we had 5 pieces of this brown doctor's luggage.
Yeah.
Okay. And you brought 2 bags with you to Tampa.
Correct.
And you left 2 bags behind, and you borrowed a black smaller bag from Grandma Richie to go back home to Mississippi. Do you recall that?
I remember I brought to carry-on in a huge one.
Right.
But I wasn't sure if I took the carry-on with me or I left it. I wasn't sure. I can't recall that.
Okay. I'm going to show you three images that I marked as defense exhibit 1A, B, and C. Ask if you recognize these images. You recognize those? This one I would introduce defense exhibit 1A, B, and C for purposes of this motion to perpetuate.
Okay.
I'm going to show you. One A. That appeared to be a photograph with two suitcases in it.
Yeah.
And do they appear to be similar suitcases?
The other one is a little bit far, and I'm not sure if
okay. The same. Okay. The suitcases that you had, the doctor suitcases, were they brown?
Yes.
And did they have, was it a cloth material?
Yeah.
And so you're not sure, these may both be your doctor suitcases?
No, the first one is mine.
Okay, what about the second one at the corner?
The second one, I'm not sure.
Okay, so what I'm saying is, the second one may be your suitcase if it in fact was a doctor's suitcase.
Is it the same brown and...
Sure. When you look at this image, can you tell whether or not these suitcases have anything inside of them? Whether they're empty or full?
I mean, I'm sitting here. It looks like...
If you can.
I'm not sure, but it... I mean, if the luggage is empty, you know it is empty, but it looks like mine or something in it. I'm not sure.
Okay, would you say the one that's closest?
Yeah, the one is the next closest, yeah.
Looks like it's...
like it has something in it, yeah.
Okay, and what about the one in the corner? Does it look like it's full as well?
That looks like it has a different material, like a powder.
Okay. You have your own exhibits. I'm going to show you State's exhibit.
Like I said, I had packed everything on the shelf. I had to get everything out. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Would you agree that it looks like the items in the suitcase are in there somewhat orderly?
Yeah, it
looks like, yeah. Okay, it's not piled in there like you see on the floor.
Right.
Okay. But you don't know whether or not you had packed that like that or someone else packed it like that?
Well, I mean, I packed my stuff when I came, but like I said, I have put everything on the shelf. I mean, he asked me to bring everything out and just hang it. Yeah, so that's what I did.
I'm going to show you the fancy exhibit 1C. And it may be difficult to see on the television screen, and I can bring the picture to you. But does that appear to be another brown suitcase?
Brown.
Okay. You want me to bring it to you so you can take a closer look at it? Okay.
Yeah,
it does
look like my
outer luggage. Okay. And there's a little logo, like a little plate at the bottom of the suitcase. Does that look consistent with the Dockers logo? Time that you were seeing Mr. Ritchie, that you were going through a separation with your husband?
Correct.
Were you and your husband still living at the same address?
Yes.
And that would be the address that was provided to ATF during the interview?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Did you tell the investigators with ATF when they interviewed you on May 22nd, 2014, that you and your husband were going through a separation?
I think so.
Do you think or you know?
I think so. I forget.
Okay.
So, I don't remember.
When you traveled to Florida to visit Granville Ritchie, did you tell your husband that you were going to visit Granville Ritchie? What did you tell him?
I told him I was going to visit a friend.
Did you tell him that you were going to Florida with co-workers?
I mean, he always know I go out of town with co-workers all the time, so.
Did you tell him you were going with co-workers to Florida?
Like I said, I don't recall that.
You indicated that when you received a phone call from Mr. Ritchie about a little bit after 11 o'clock in the evening, where he said to you that he wants to go back and get back to work,
uh-huh.
Did that make you happy?
Yes.
In that conversation, he said he wants to get back to work and move out of state and start a new life.
Correct.
Okay. Did you, in fact, know that when he first met you, Mr. Ritchie was working out of state?
Yeah, that's what he told me, that he traveled.
Right. And he traveled and worked with cell phone towers?
Yes.